Chicago, Chicago, that toddling town. Chicago, Chicago, I will show you around. I love it that you bottom dollar, you lose the blues in Chicago, Chicago, the town that Billy Sunday couldn't shut down. On State Street, that great street, I just want to say, they do things they don't do on Broadway. They have the time of their life. I saw a man, he danced with his wife in Chicago, Chicago, my hometown. Chicago, Chicago, that toddling town. Chicago, Chicago, I'll show you.
We're friends of Herb Cupson, but every Chicago was a friend of Herb Cupson.
Chicago, Chicago, that toddling town. Chicago, Chicago, I will show you around. I love it that you bottom dollar, you lose the blues in Chicago, Chicago, the town that Billy Sunday couldn't shut down. On State Street, that great street, I just want to say, they do things they don't do on Broadway. They have the time of their life.
One of the world's most famous columnists for many years. But he never forgot where his roots were. His roots were Chicago. And he did everything he could to promote the city. But he was read in every city in America and actually throughout the world. His column was so influential. So many actors, entertainers, and politicians wanted to be in that column because if their name appeared and it was positive, it always was positive with Cup. He never wrote unkind things about anyone. Their stock went up, and so Hollywood especially wanted to have their actors appear in that column. They would come in on the train from L.A., stop at Union Station, Cup would have them picked up, they'd go to the Ambassador East, they'd meet him at his booth in the pump room, and then he would interview them for the column. When it was done, they'd hop back on the train, they'd either go back to LA or go to New York.
Chicago, Chicago, that toddling town. Chicago, Chicago, I will show you around. I love it that you bottom dollar, you lose the blues in Chicago, Chicago, the town that Billy Sunday couldn't shut down. On State Street.
Always interviewed these national celebrities, and as I said, they would hop on a train and come here from Chicago, and they would become part of his column. Well, Bill Van Damme, who was one of Cupp's really close friends, a best buddy right till the end, loved Cary Grant. And so Cupp knew that, and Cupp told Bill, "Bill, Cary Grant's coming in to Union Station tomorrow. I'm going to interview him in my booth at the pump room." "Oh my God," Bill said. And that at that point, Cupp said, "Why don't you come and join us?" "Oh, no, I can't believe this. You're inviting me to be with Cary Grant." Well, Bill absolutely adored Cary Grant. But then Bill said, "Well, Cupp, I have a date tomorrow. What about that?" "Go bring her. Cary would like that. I'm sure she would." So Bill said, "Great." So then Bill thought about it. He had another young lady he was trying to impress. So he canceled the first date, and he asked the second girl to come to the luncheon with Cary Grant. So when he sat down and introduced everybody, he said, "Cary, I just have to say, Mr. Grant, you are everything I would want. I love the way you talk, the way you dress, the way you walk, everything about you. Cary Grant, you are my icon."
Hi, I'm Irene Michaels, and I've lived in Chicago most of my life. And of course, we know Mr. Chicago, which is Irv Kupsinen. Irv Kupsinen, you are unbelievable, have always been unbelievable. You're still with us, you and Essie. I remember when I was smoking cigarettes back in the day in the green room with Essie. And it's your birthday, and we're still celebrating you. How great is that? I remember when I first met you with Bill Van Damme and Walter Jacobson and Joey Mahonda. We all just always used to meet at the pump room, and all the celebrities used to come up to you and want to speak to Mr. Chicago, of course. And my dear friend Joey Mahonda, I know he celebrated your 60th anniversary and your 90th anniversary with your Cubs column. And so this was absolutely wonderful. And we're still thinking of you today, so that's such a great testimony to you.